Hi, are you running a bicycle showroom? Are you selling cycles to kids or for cycling enthusiasts? Then watch this video carefully. Because in this video, I will be explaining what are all the effective Facebook ad methods to get more customers for your bicycle showroom with very little budget. Now let's see how you can do this. Bicycle shop usually sell bicycles to the age range of mostly between the kids range and to the youth range, right? So kids buy bicycles for the obvious reasons. They want to play with it, it increases their health, and they need some physical activity, right? So usually the parents buy these kids bicycle for their loved ones. And the other part of the people is that they buy the cycles for, maybe they are buying it for cycling to improve their health, or some people even buy it for sports, like they want to have a cardio or exercise, or even cycling as their passion. Now, if you want to get both type of these customers, you have to understand their customer's persona. Customer's persona, you don't need to worry. What is customer's persona? I have never even heard of it. Don't need to worry. Customer persona is very simple to understand. Customer persona is nothing but the common interests of these customers. For example, you imagine a customer who is very nice. I mean, like, who is very interested in buying a bicycle and who even not even negotiated while buying your bicycle. So you have to imagine about your most suitable, most ideal customer. And you have to imagine about what are all their interests, what type of interest they usually have. What is their age? What is their income level? What is their job type? What are the industries they are working in? What are the brands they will be liking in? What are all the movie stars? What are the type of celebrities, personalities they will be liking? You have to understand all of these things. And it is very, very, very easy. Because if you have a friend, I mean, like, if you make a friend, if you make your customer as your Facebook friend, then you have the access to most of these things. You just have to follow them on Facebook. So you now know what type of interest they are in, what type of status updates they are doing, what type of jobs they are in, and all sorts of things, right? Now, how to use this customer persona for Facebook ads? Facebook is an absolutely wonderful medium which understands the things that you are telling them to show your advertisements to your target audience. So that is categorized in three types. One is the interest-based targeting. The other one is behavioral-based targeting. The third one is demographic-based targeting. Interest-based targeting means, as I have already told you, what are all the common interests of your customers? Like, what are the movies they usually watch? What are all the brands they usually follow? All sorts of these interests. Once you add very close relevant interests that you know from your customers, Facebook automatically suggests you the other interest. But be very careful, read it properly, and just make a decision. Think for a second if it is really the interest of your customers. Even if Facebook tells you, just think for a second, okay, I have entered this brand as my customer's interest. Like, for example, if Atlas cycles, you know, right? Atlas is one of the interests that customers are following. That means they might have an Atlas cycle already, or they are interested in Atlas buying a cycle. Or there may be some pages like cycling enthusiast, right? Chennai cycling enthusiast. You can have this interest in your ad targeting, and Facebook will automatically show you what are all the other cycling groups in Chennai or Mumbai or Kolkata. It's very easy, right? So it's not as difficult as you think. Once you get started, everything will be very easy. But just think, use your business knowledge in determining which are relevant interests, which are not relevant interests. So next thing is the demographic. Demographic is very easy. As you know, demographic is nothing but the statistical information of your customers, their age range, what is the range of their age, like what are the types of customers you are coming to your shop, and what is their age range, where is the minimum age limit and maximum age limit who are frequently coming to your shop for purchasing the bicycles. It can be like 5 years to 30 years, or it can be like 10 years to 40 years and all. And gender, it's a little bit tricky, because some cases fathers buy the cycles for their kids, and in some cases mothers. So you cannot able to omit a particular gender, because may both of these genders may be a deciding factor in buying a bicycle, right? So decide as whatever it suits your area, locality, and types of cycles you are selling. And for if you are only selling kid cycle, then I would suggest you limit the customer's persona that suits for kid cycle. Then third one is behavioral targeting. Behavioral targeting is the most crucial element that you can use to accurately guide Facebook ads to show your ads only to the relevant people. So now you have already said Facebook what all the interest they will be having. So you have already told Facebook what are all the relevant interests they are having, right? Now you have already said the age range, gender, locality, and all these things in demographic. Interest, demographic is all set. Now you want to help Facebook more accurately in finding your customers. Now that's what we are going to use behavioral targeting. Behavioral targeting is nothing but telling Facebook what type of lifestyles your customers are following. Using behavioral targeting, you can even tell if you want to target on customers who are having a particular type of cell phone. For example, if you are selling costly cycles, who will buy costly cycles, right? Only those people who are having higher income capacity. Who are having higher income capacity? People who are usually using luxury goods and costly items, right? So you can use this common sense in identifying what are all the most suitable behavioral targeting. Like for example, you can add iPhone users, you can add OnePlus One users, you can add frequent air travelers who are traveling on flight frequently, who are visiting other countries. So all these people are having they are having a very good income range, right? You can add all these types into your behavioral targeting. Now you know how to target your customers, right? How to find the customers who will be interested in your projects. Interested in buying bicycles. Okay. Now you need to find out how to make them actually buy. Now this is the most tricky and difficult part, right? You have found out who are going to buy, but you need to make them buy. That is the most difficult and interesting element. How can you do that? It's not as difficult as you think if you follow these three simple rules. One is you have to incentivize, you have to give some incentives to your customer that makes them believe that your bicycle store is the best value for the money they are spending, is the best money they can spend. Your shop is the best. No one should tell me that after buying the cycle, no one should tell me that, oh God, you have purchased your cycle on this shop, why not buy this on this shop? This is having lots of freebies, offers, they are giving free door delivery, they are giving have 1 year of maintenance for free, and all these things. So incentivizing is the number one element that's going to make the customer consider buying from you. So plan your incentives very properly. Think like, what are all the main pain points of selling a bicycle? What are all the main things that customers usually ask you? What they ask you? They may ask you what is the free warranty period? Do you provide, do you have the spares? All sorts of things, right? You have to think about it and you have to create the best incentive that will attract the customers. The second thing is that make them feel special. If you are unable to make them feel special, then the sales will be monotonous. It will be boring and less interesting. How you can make them feel special? It's also very simple if you follow this trick. Take a look at your last 100 customers and find which type of customers are giving you more sales. Like if kid cycle are selling the most, it is selling the most quantity, it is giving you the higher revenue, then you can have words like only for the kids below 15 years, only for the kids below 10 years. So you already know that majority of your sales happens from the kids below the age of 10, and you are mentioning that in your ad, which means that those people will be highly attracted to your ad. They feel a personal connect between your brand and themselves. They used to feel like, okay, I am very eligible, I'm an eligible person to get this offer, so why should I miss this offer? Right, simple psychology tactic that you should be using. The third thing is that create a fear of missing. So Using the first tactic, incentivizing them, you have made them think that if I want to buy a bicycle, I want to buy it on your shop. That's a decision you have made using incentivizing them. The second thing is that you have made them feel special. Okay, so let me see if I can able to buy this because I have this offer, right? Now, you want to make them buy actually. You want to make them call your business. You want to make them visit your showroom. You want to make them buy. How can you do that? You have to create a fear of missing out. Fear of missing out is nothing but if you do not act on this ad right now, you will be missing a bigger thing. Like this sales ends on, this special sale ends in 5 days. Or only 100 special signature cycles available for sales. So this will make the kids or those cycling enthusiasts to react on your ad. So reacting means they might be asking you, they might be commenting on your ad, like if the stocks is still available, can I come tomorrow to buy, all sorts of things. So it's a very, 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 very good thing to follow these three tactics. So I hope you like this video. I will be making a lot more videos in future to help your business grow. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and also like my Facebook page. Thank you. See you again.